Casey Neistat doesn't create to live, he lives to create. And in this video, we're gonna deconstruct how Casey avoids creative burnout by turning the monotony of everyday life into vibrant vignettes. So shades on, let's go. In college, I watched Casey's daily vlogs and I thought to myself, this is what I want to do with my life. The art, the passion, the consistency, all of it. And as I explored it, I realized that it turns out that Casey's story begins with a defiant kid who challenged all kinds of conventional norms.
I've only ever had one mission in life, and that mission has been to simply realize the promises I made to myself when I was a kid.
Casey got kicked out of school when he was 15 years old, and then he ran away with his girlfriend, who soon got pregnant, and then lived for a while in a trailer park. But Casey had to keep going. It's who he is. He had to keep finding ways to defy all those people who said, you can't do it. And so he packed up all his things and moved to the one place where he knew that no one could tell him what to do. New York City.
New York City is a place where you can do anything and be anything because everyone is too damn busy to worry about what anyone else is doing.
And since he arrived, he started living by his own theory of constraints, where he uses his limiting forces in his life as creative source material. He looks at the world and he asks, what is the story that already exists here? And doing that turns static obstacles into dynamic assets, which become the subjects of Casey's videos. His first viral video came from the constraints of his iPod battery life. In an act of guerrilla art, Casey filmed himself spray painting warnings about how iPods don't have enough battery life on street ads all around New York City. And guess what? That same year, Apple announced a battery replacement policy and an extended iPod warranty program. How's that for influence? And then later, another viral video was the result of the constraints of a bike lane.
I'm getting a ticket for riding my bike not in the bike lane.
After getting a fine for riding outside of the bike lane, Casey saw an opportunity to explore the hypocrisy of New York City laws. And so he videoed himself catapulting on his bike and his body into any obstacle, truck or police car, because if it was in the bike path, he wasn't allowed to leave. Time and again, Casey turned his constraints into a centerpiece of his creative work. And when filming, he'd often have to look away from the lens and look up at the screen above it to check his framing. But the problem was that meant that his eye would wander away from the lens, and Casey didn't ever want to lose connection with his audience. And so, he started wearing black sunglasses for every video.
I'm not looking into the lens, I'm looking into this screen right here. And that way I can frame things up, I know what I'm looking at.
As he gained popularity, he'd have all kinds of meetings around New York too. But once again, he had a problem that transportation can be expensive and inconvenient. It's a limiting force. And so instead of taking a cab or the subway, he filmed himself riding an electric skateboard all over the city. He turned transportation into a motif and New York City into a character on his vlogs. And then tons of packages started arriving at his office, lots of them. And to deliver all those packages, the UPS guy would have to park on the street and then make multiple trips up and down the elevator to deliver everything to Casey's office. But did Casey see all those packages and that hardworking UPS guy as a problem to be solved? Or as an opportunity to be captured? The guy's name was Marlon, and Casey turned him into a character on the vlog, and eventually Marlon became the most well-known UPS guy in all of New York City. And by doing all of that, Casey twisted life's mundane moments into these quirky little bits, at once so relatable, but still just so Casey. And Casey's friend, Dan Mace, described the creative process well when he said, "To me, creativity is the ability to believe in the way in which you see the world so much that you actually create an art form out of it." In March 2015, Casey launched his daily vlog that would continue for 534 days, and he set a rule for himself: publish daily. And within that rigid constraint, Casey was forced to find inspiration. He did it all himself. He set up the shots, captured the video, transferred files to his computer, edited the video, made graphics, added music, uploaded it to YouTube, and then pressed publish. And that vlog was a huge success. And now people think of Casey as an expert vlogger, one of the most famous vloggers in the world. And they talk about him like he was an overnight success. But when they do, they forget the 10 years of silence before that. See, Casey had been vlogging for years, far before the idea of a vlog was cool or popular. And so let's rewind back to 2008. Casey and his brother, Van, were creating a first-person autobiographical miniseries. And when all the other indie filmmakers at the time were pointing their cameras outward, Casey decided to point his inward. He wasn't just doing what he thought would be popular. He was expressing his creative DNA, and his style was so unique that it got picked up by HBO with a show he hosted with his brother called The Neistat Brothers. And though it actually aired in 2010, well, it was canceled after just one season. See, the world wasn't ready for Casey yet. So what happened? Well, Casey got down for a while. He did get into a creative rut, and he started to doubt himself. But then some time passed, and he said, you know what? I can do this. I can defy the odds just like I've always done in my life. Casey was accustomed to obstacles. He never went to college. He certainly never went to film school. And he had his first kid when he was a teenager. But he also knew that if he abandoned his style just because the public didn't appreciate it at the time, he'd be giving up what made him special. And so he doubled down on the whole Casey vibe. He kept creating, he kept exploring and refining the art of short-form, first-person autobiographical storytelling. Because he started to think that if his HBO audience wouldn't tune in, well, maybe his YouTube audience would. And sure enough, the world eventually came around to Casey. Not because he changed, but because the world changed in a way that made his innate style relevant. And that's when Casey exploded. In 2012, Nike asked Casey to make a film about what it means to make it count. And to make it, Casey took 10 days to travel the world with the money that Nike paid him. First, he visited the Eiffel Tower in France, then the pyramids in Egypt, then South Africa, Zambia, Kenya, Italy, Thailand, Singapore, and Japan. All that in just 10 days. And on that trip, he inked himself with a tattoo that has defined his career since. And it says, "Do more." And 2 years later, he started that daily vlog. By 2016, he'd published a video every single day for 534 days. And he was getting millions of views on his YouTube channel and won GQ's New Media Star Man of the Year award. By 2020, Casey had released over 1,000 videos on his YouTube channel, and it had more than 12 million subscribers. See, now he was in control. And he teamed up for a sponsored video with Samsung, where he flew over the Hollywood sign in Los Angeles, while hanging onto a rope ladder while twirling from the bottom of a helicopter. Which, comes to think of it, reminds me of the time he wakeboarded through Amsterdam wearing a tuxedo, or the time he snowboarded through Times Square. Casey succeeds because he approaches his reality, not as it is, but how he perceives it. He sees what's possible instead of submitting to what's given to him. And then he creates opportunities for himself. And instead of asking for permission, he says, to hell with it. Let's just take action. He cuts through the BS, he pursues his singular vision, and expresses it with passionate intensity.
Oh, I'm so psyched about this thing, man. Oh, wow!
And the result has been an artist who has defined this generation by making videos not for the sake of sophistication or complexity, but for the virtue of clarity and simplicity. Casey ain't fancy. Well, with the exception of drone shots like these. But seriously, there are no fancy graphics or crazy animations. Just a dose of cool, a splatter of personality, youthful playfulness, and timeless storytelling inspired by his favorite movie, The Godfather, and his favorite movie director, Wes Anderson. And in what's become my very favorite Casey anecdote, he says, "Expressing creativity using the most basic, accessible methods is the hardest thing to do and the purest. The very best steakhouses serve their filet on a plate with nothing else. Shitty franchises cover theirs in sauce and other stuff to distract you from the fact that you're eating dog food." And so the next time you decide to create, think of Casey and ask yourself, What are you serving up? Is it steak or sauce? If you want to learn about the process of another, albeit very different filmmaker, check out my other video on Christopher Nolan.